Today we will discuss the art of Mickey Mousing, its variation and its interpretative quality. Mickey Mousing is a synchronization of the score with the actions in the scene. The following films will show the interpretive quality of Mickey Mousing as a valuable film technique. Steamboat Willie is an animation film released in 1928 by Walt Disney Studio. This film had a huge impact on the film industry in several ways. On the one hand, it's the first Mickey Mouse cartoon by Walt Disney. On the other hand, it's the first known use of Mickey Mousing where their music almost completely works to mimic the animated motions of the characters. The film uses Mickey Mousing in two different ways. On the one hand, we have the song coordinated to the action, which is visible in the opening sequence where Mickey Mouse moves to the beat of his own whistling. On the other hand, we have the action coordinated to the song, where Mickey Mouse and Minnie play a version of Turkey and Destroyer using animals, and every action is perfectly coordinated to the beat of the music. It enables the music to be seen to participate in the action, to also intensify the experience of the scene for the spectator. Firstly, we'll have a look at two films where we use well-known pieces and coordinate the images to match the beat of that specific song. In this film, the technique of Mickey Mousing supports the idea that the protagonist's baby is sealed off from the outside world. He is immersed in his own world where every action of his is perfectly coordinated with his iPod playlist. The film explains this by giving us a deeper insight into the protagonist's baby. The reason behind his constant need to listen to music is caused by a childhood accident which resulted in tinnitus, which he tries to drown out by using earphones. As a result, Baby orchestrates his life to carefully chosen playlists. While his fellow gangsters rob the bank, he sits in the car listening to the music, seemingly sealed off from the outside world with his dark sunglasses and earbuds. While waiting, he coordinates the windshield wipers to the beat of the music. Another perfect example would be when he replays the song several times so it functions perfectly with his actions. He is the one who synchronizes the beat to his following actions.
Okay, go!
In a way, he's manipulating our experience of Mickey Mousing. He is the one in power. He shapes our experience. In Shaun of the Dead, we can already find an early stage of Mickey Mousing. Nevertheless, it's still in a more primitive state compared to what he accomplished with his latest film, Baby Driver. The Mickey Mousing in this case is mostly used for comedic relief and to promote the idea of being on a concert. On the one hand, we have the humans who are trying to survive. They're hitting the zombified old man on the beat of the song Don't Stop Me Now by Queen. In addition, David tries to find the correct switch on the switchboard so that the jukebox stops playing the song and gather attention. He manipulates the switches exactly on the beat of the song and the lights go on and off accordingly. On the other hand, we have the zombies who are behaving like the crowd at the concert, moving their arms and shaking their heads to the beat of the music. Secondly, we'll have a look at films where the score is created by the action. Junu and Karo, the directors, want to give you the proximity of the little apartment complex, and all its eccentric tenants engage in one activity or another, ranging from the protagonist attempting to paint a ceiling to the butcher having sex with one of his tenants. They were able to achieve that by connecting parallel editing with Mickey Mousing. The different sounds come all together to create one universal soundscape. In other words, the actions and the sound it creates are audible over the whole parallel editing and thereby creating a score. The bed spring act as a metronome and thereby giving the whole scene its rhythm. As you can see, the tenons are perfectly synchronized with the squeaking of the bed springs. When the squeaking of the bed springs enhances in speed, everybody's action and thereby its sounds accelerate, and the scene ends in a literal climax. In Requiem for a Dream, the monotone voice of the Doctor becomes part of the score. The different characters are connected to each other by the Mickey Mousing. In other words, while switching between the different characters, the phrase is repeated over and over again. The sentence connects perfectly with the situation Sarah is in. The phrase reminds us of what the Doctor is saying when you are getting hospitalized. In the other case, Aronofsky uses the part of the sentence, "Can you see me?" at the exact moment the shot switches to a POV of Marion. Aronofsky even uses light to strengthen the aforementioned bond between characters by connecting the flashlight of the Doctor and the work camp with the light cast on Marion's face. In conclusion, I hope through my development I was able to show the true power of Mickey Mousing, and hopefully in the future we will be able to see the creative usage of Mickey Mousing more often.